I recently created a kinetic typography tutorial for the channel, and in that we had this animated gradient snake effect that was cool but didn't really have much to do with kinetic typography. But it was a little bit of a process to get it working, so in this video let me break down exactly how I did it. Now the TLDR of it all is that it isn't possible to do completely natively in After Effects. You will need a third-party script, and we will get to that. The why of it all? Well, I created this animation based on style frames provided to me by our designer Ian, which is a common workflow. He of course created those style frames over in Illustrator, and I wanted to stay as faithful to his still assets as possible when it came to animating them. Obviously, I could just trace the path in After Effects to match his style frame, but adding the gradient to the path would have been the issue. I didn't want the gradient to animate along the path, I wanted the gradient to stay static along the path while that path expanded via a trim path animation. This is not possible natively in After Effects, so what's the workaround? Well, it's a script called Thicc Stroke, and yes, Thicc Stroke is with two C's, and it's awesome. And generally, I'm not going to send you on a wild goose chase for, you know, really expensive paid plugins and things like that, but this was something that was a little bit of a battle for me to get right in After Effects. It ended up looking cool, and the plugin is free, and you can get it at the designer's site, which is Plugin Everything, or find it on AE Scripts. It's a super handy little plugin. And you know what else is super handy? This video is brought to you by Envato, the unlimited creative subscription. The broadest range of categories, everything that you need to make great videos. Follow the link in the description and start creating now. So I've got the original Illustrator file loaded up in the background, and in After Effects I create a new composition. I'm going to be outputting the main comp at 1080p, 25 frames per second, and it's going to be about 15 seconds long based on the music track that I've selected. So this new comp, which we'll call Gradient Snake, is going to need to be much bigger than that so I can kind of blow it up and then reposition freely within the main comp. I'll use the preset 4K, 25 frames per second composition, but double the height, which I can easily do by adding a multiplier next to 2160 by typing an asterisk and 2 to double it, so like times 2. Now in that comp, I will create a new black solid and call it Snake. I'll then jump quickly over to Illustrator and make sure I'm copying the paths from this black version, and then I'll come back to After Effects, select my pen tool, and make sure that I've got my snake layer selected. I'll single click to create a mask point in this comp, then down here I'll drop down the mask properties, or you can hit M on your keyboard a couple of times, then I'll select the mask path and hit Command plus V to paste the mask path from Illustrator. You'll see that has dropped in down here, but it doesn't have any stroke info applied. Now, if you've got the Thicc Stroke plugin loaded up, you can then go to Effects and Presets and drag Thicc Stroke onto this layer. By default, it adds some tapering to the stroke, but it's easy to get it consistent with by changing the width, start, and end values to 100. At this point, it's probably handy to bring the original Illustrator file into After Effects as a reference for the thickness of the stroke, as well as to help when applying the color gradient correctly in the next step. You'll see that once we do bring in that original asset, it has a butt cap, not a round cap, and then when we apply Thicc Stroke, it has defaulted to round. You can change it back to butt if you need, however, it will kind of start to break gradients a little, like you can see here if I demonstrate it. So this is one of those moments in an imperfect process where you get to take a little creative liberty and say, well, I guess we're going with round cap, not butt cap. To create the gradient, it's really simple, if not just a little bit time consuming, depending on the reference that you're working with. Our one has a lot of color shifts. I'll make our reference small and bring it down here in the corner just so that we have it accessible to use with the color picker. Let's also open up this window here just a little bit bigger to give ourselves a little bit more space to play with. Alrighty, on the gradient slider here, you can see these little color tags down below, and the whole bar represents our snake from start to finish, left to right. To match up the gradient I have in this reference, I'll start by creating the yellow. I can do that by dragging this original color tag to the start, double clicking it, and then using the color picker from the color dialog box to select exactly the hue that we're going for in our reference. I'll then move forward a little bit on the gradient bar, and I'm sort of just eyeballing this right now, and create a secondary yellow marker, again with the exact same color as the first. I like to color pick from the original marker just to make sure that it's exactly the same and we're not shifting over time. So what we've done there is create the in and out point of the gradient, so to speak. I'll then create a new tag just to the right of the out point of the yellow, make this our second color, which is red, and then move forward a little bit and create another tag as the same red. This is now the out point for our red. Now you can see where the out point of the original yellow and the in point for the red sits on the gradient bar, and you can see that determines where the gradient crossover is happening on our path. And then also how feathered the gradient is determined by how close together the tags are. So let's move these out so that they match our reference. The gradient transition should happen sort of somewhere at the bottom of this loop. All right, so now you just kind of rinse and repeat that process. So I'm going to go through, add a little time lapse here, and create all of our gradient color jumps. It's a pretty swish little plugin. Now that we have the gradients complete, you can play with the trim paths, which are also built into the plugin. And if you're not familiar with what trim paths are, it's basically a way to animate a stroke along the path from start to finish, or finish to start, or a combination of the two. And there you go, a way to control the gradient along a path that is being animated here in After Effects, which is not something you can do natively, but thanks to this handy little plugin, which again is called Thicc Stroke. You can get it for free at Plugin Everything or on AE Scripts. With the help of that handy little plugin, you can make some pretty cool little effects here. So what do you think you might use this technique for? And are there any other kind of things that you would love to be able to do in After Effects that you can't do natively, but have to use third-party plugins for? Let me know in the comments. I'm all ears. So I hope that little look at my workflow was helpful, and until next time, keep it snaky.